الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له. ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له. ونشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا ومولانا محمدا عبده ورسوله. أما بعد، فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. وما آتاكم الرسول فخذوه وما نهاكم عنه فانتهوا. صدق الله العظيم. سبحانك لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري وحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. جلوش يقلح Respected brothers, respected elders, mothers and sisters listening at home. Continuing with the Khilafat of Sayyidina Ali ibn Abi Talib radiyallahu ta'ala an. In the last two sessions, I had given an explanation of the brief biography of two great companions, Hazrat Musa al-Ashari radiyallahu ta'ala an and Hazrat Amr ibn al-As radiyallahu ta'ala an, two great companions of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And intentionally I had taken a bit of time trying to cover the entire seerah, how Amr ibn al-As radiyallahu ta'ala an became a Muslim, the title given to Hazrat Musa al-Ashari radiyallahu ta'ala an, their connection with Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, relationship with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, their contributions for the service of Islam, their jihad, their death, and how close they were to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and also the basharat, the glad tidings given to them, so that we understand that these are companions and solid companions of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that they have the complete backing of the greatest creation of Allah, who is Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Unfortunately, when you read history books today, and especially the Battle of Jamal and the Battle of Siffin that occurred during the Khilafat of Hazrat Ali radiyallahu ta'ala an, you will find that the authors have not done justice to understand the status of these great companions of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and especially Hazrat Musa al-Ashari and Hazrat Amr ibn al-As radiyallahu ta'ala an. And it seems that there has been an effort by the enemies of Islam to distort the image of these great companions of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Just recently, a few days ago, I was listening to the lecture of this scholar in Pakistan, and he was a Shia before, and all of his lectures were in Farsi. Then he came to Pakistan, and mashallah, he became a Muslim, and he was explaining that I'm a man who was extremely close to Khomeini. I'm a man who was extremely close to Ayatollah Khomeini. And Khomeini said to me that my dream is that Pakistan becomes a land in which the fiqh of Ja'fari is promoted. The fiqh of Ja'fari, that is the Shia doctrine. is promoted. But unfortunately, there is one scholar, one alim, that is an obstacle to us, whose name is Maulana Haq Nawaz Jangvi. Can you imagine that? That is Iran. And politics, you know, politics is dirty. Subhanallah. The nitty gritty that's being played in politics. And so he says that Khomeini said to me that I want to promote Sikh Jafari in Pakistan. But there's one obstacle that comes from one scholar, one powerful alim, whose name is Maulana Haq Nawaz Jangvi. Allah give him Jannah. Allahu Akbar. What a scholar. Because until he is alive, nothing can happen in Pakistan. And so anyway, this alim, who was a Shia scholar first, he came and he studied this man, Maulana Haq Nawaz Jangvi, and started listening to his lectures. And eventually Allah opened his heart and he did tawbah and istighfar, repented, and he became from amongst the Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'at. Allah gives hidayah to whom he will. So there is this concerted effort, a well-coordinated effort out there, Allahu Akbar, to weaken the foundation of Islam. And this started from the time of Nabiya Kareem sallallahu alayhi wasallam. You pick up any book, and if it talks negatively about any of the Sahaba, any of the companions of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam, throw that book away. If you're not a scholar, throw it away. Don't even continue reading that book. Subhanallah. It's very important that we understand that. And so many books today you open up, especially about Jangi Jamal and Jangi Sifin, and people speak negatively about these two companions appointed by Hazrat Ali and appointed by Hazrat Amir Muawiyah radiallahu ta'ala an. For an example, just to quote, they say that Hazrat Ali had appointed Hazrat Musa al-Ashari radiallahu ta'ala an to be his referee and arbitrator for the Iraqi people who were with Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala an. And Hazrat Amr ibn al-As is the referee for the Syrians and the arbitrator for the Amir Muawiyah radiallahu ta'ala. Remember, as in after the battle of Siffin, it was agreed that the arbitration plan will take place, and you'll have two individuals from both the groups who will resolve this issue. And so only the best were selected by these companions. And Hazrat Ali did not select a tabi'een, he selected a sahabi, who is Hazrat Musa al-Ashari. Hazrat Muawiyah did not select a tabi'een, he selected a sahabi, who is Amr ibn al-As radiallahu ta'ala. And they say that both of them met in the month of Ramadan. Historians have said that 37 year of Hijri, and it was the month of Ramadan, in a location which is known as Dawmatul Jundul, between Syria and Iraq. And so that is where the meeting took place between Hazrat Musa al-Ashari radiallahu ta'ala an and Amr ibn al-As radiallahu ta'ala an. And I'm sorry if I may have haunted some individuals, but this is a series of the Khilafatul Rashida, of the companions of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam. So what happens is that every Friday, if you miss one dars, then you'll most probably be disconnected. And it's actually just a continuation from one chapter to another chapter, and all the events and the sequence that occurred. And so it's just a continuation. We have explained everything, alhamdulillah, thoroughly, with regards to the Battle of Jamal and the Battle of Siffin. And so when both of them met at Dawmatul Jundul, Hazrat Amr ibn al-As radiallahu ta'ala an started the conversation with Hazrat Musa al-Ashari radiallahu ta'ala an. And he said to Hazrat Musa al-Ashari that the Syrians will not accept Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala an to be a Khalifa. The reason for that is, we will only accept Hazrat Ali if he hands over the rebels to the Syrians, to those who are related to the family of Hazrat Uthman radiallahu ta'ala an. And until now, this has not happened, and therefore we say that in a way, what they were saying is Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala an is indirectly associated with the murder of Hazrat Uthman radiallahu ta'ala an, al-iyazu billah. Now, can anyone imagine the likes of Hazrat Amr ibn al-As radiallahu ta'ala an, a great Sahabi, in a meeting with another great Sahabi, Hazrat Musa al-Ashari radiallahu ta'ala an, and here they are talking about who will be the Khalifa, when this was never the point of contention or the point of dispute. This was never the issue. But you open up majority of the books and this is what you will find. Aliyazu billah. And in some of the books, they don't even label Hazrat Amir-e-Muawiyah as Hazrat Amir-e-Muawiyah. And they'll say, oh, Muawiyah did that. Muawiyah, Allahu Akbar. Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. Disrespecting a Sahabi of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So everyone else, Hazrat, Hazrat, Hazrat. And I had seen this with my own eyes when we went to Syria. The companions who are not from amongst the Ahlul Bayt, the Syrian government, Alawi government, has not looked after the graves of the companions who are not from the Ahlul Bayt. But those who are from the Ahlul Bayt, it's well maintained, looked after, everything, there is a good covering, and everything is quite neat in that area. You can just see clearly, if you go to the qubur of the companions, that even now, you will find that there is that grudge, unfortunately, that you will find one particular group of people that only chooses a few and a handful of companions and discards the rest. Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. So we have to be very, very careful, my respected brothers. Our iman must be strong. Our aqeedah must be strong. Look at Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala. After the demise of Hazrat Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, single-handedly he stood up. And he said, I will do jihad with those people who refuse to give zakat. Lions like Hazrat Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu ta'ala, and powerful individuals, would come and say to Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq, that look, we need to be a bit diplomatic, take time, not now, it's alright, if they're not giving zakat, let's wait. And Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala and got angry. And says, Umar, from you I'm hearing this. From you I'm hearing this. If you don't want to come, none of you can come. Abu Bakr alone will go and do jihad with them. Iman. That is iman. What is right, and what is wrong. This is not a fiqhi ikhtilaf. That can be understood. If somebody is saying salah like this, and if somebody is following the fiqh of Imam Shafi'i, understood. Somebody is following the fiqh of Imam Malik, that is understood. If somebody is following the fiqh of Imam Abu Hanifa, that is understood. That difference of opinion is understood. But as far as aqaid is concerned, the foundation, there is no compromise with that, my respected brothers and elders. We have to understand what is right and what is wrong. And they say that Hazrat Amr ibn al-As radiallahu ta'ala and tricked Hazrat Musa al-Ashari radiallahu ta'ala. And says, look, we can't accept him as a Khalifa. So the Syrians won't accept him as a Khalifa because we haven't got the rebels. Those who played a part in Aliyazu Billah murdering Hazrat Uthman radiallahu ta'ala. And then Hazrat Amir Muawiyah radiallahu ta'ala, Hazrat Amr ibn al-As radiallahu ta'ala and said to Hazrat Musa al-Ashari that I also understand that Hazrat Amir Muawiyah can be the Khalifa. Now what kind of a meeting is this? Imagine both have been elected by their seniors. And both of them, Aliyazu Billah, the picture that is given to us, they go against their seniors. Is that the meeting they had? As the Hazrat Amr ibn al-As is saying to Hazrat Musa al-Ashari, that Amir Muawiyah can't also be the Khalifa. Why? Because we understand Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala and his status is much higher than Hazrat Amir Muawiyah. We know that. And so someone who is much higher cannot take the position. Of that person who is lower can't take that position and can't be on top of a person who is equal to, sorry, who is as highly ranked as Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala an. And Hazrat Musa al-Ashari radiallahu ta'ala an started listening to him, and what did he say? He says, I agree with you, O Amr ibn al-As. And wallahi, this is what you'll find in the books. You'll read that in the books. If a simple man is reading, he will start to wonder, what is happening here? These are companions, we hear about Sahaba-i Kiram Ajma'in, what kind of a meeting is this? This is the main meeting after the Battle of Siffin, and here you have two companions trying to rid their seniors and the Khalifa. So Hazrat Musa al-Ashari agrees, and in that meeting they say that perhaps we should now elect a neutral individual, and some names were given, like Hazrat Abdullah ibn Umar or Sa'd ibn Abi Waqqas radiallahu ta'ala an, and both of them rejected this according to the narrations given. And then Hazrat Musa al-Ashari radiallahu ta'ala an says that what we need to do is we need to remove both of the companions from their position. So Hazrat Musa al-Ashari is saying that I will depose Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala an and also remove Hazrat Amir Muawiyah radiallahu ta'ala an, and we will ask the Muslim community to elect another leader. And so this is what was agreed in that meeting. La hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. Nothing of the sort, my respected brothers and elders. What we need to understand, that if there was any discussion taken place in this meeting, this meeting which was so important after the Battle of Siffin, it was only upon the fact that when and how will the laws of qisas will be implemented? What will we do with the rebels that are in with Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala and also the rebels that are in Madinatul Munawwara? That was the discussion. But if you read the books today in history, what they want to do is they want to distort the image of the companions. And so they talk about Hazrat Musa al-Ashari radiallahu ta'ala and aliyazu billah, that he was a sellout to Hazrat Ali. And Hazrat Amr ibn al-As was also a man who was a sellout for Hazrat Amir Muawiyah radiallahu ta'ala. Whilst Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam has spoken about these great companions. And so what we need to understand, my respected brothers, we have to be very, very careful about Sahaba-i Kiram Ajma'in. All of the companions are Rijalullah. Rijalullah and Adul. And most beloved to Allah and His Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Extremely important. That is why even in Jumu'ah, you will find that the Imam will also praise Allah and His Rasul and will send durood upon Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam. But every Sunni alim will praise the companions. That is most important in a khutbah. Arhamu ummati bi ummati Abu Bakr, wa ashadduhum fi amrillahi Umar, wa ahyahum Uthman, wa aqdahum Ali, وفاطمة سيدة نساء أهل الجنة وحمزة أسد الله وأسد رسوله وعالمهم بالحلال والحرام معاذ بن الجبل وأفردهم زيد بن ثابت ولكل أمة أمين وأمين هذه الأمة أبو عبيدة بن الجراح. So the names of the companions have to be mentioned. These are the narrators of the hadith of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So we have to be extremely careful. As far as the maslak of Ahl Sunnah wal Jamaat is concerned, it is very important that we understand these events, that these were events that occurred, and the reason what occurred was due to their independent judgment and ruling. It was their independent judgment and ruling. Whatever had happened has happened, but it was due to their independent judgment and ruling. And all of them are khair and all of them were correct. That is why when Hazrat Hassan Basri rahmatullah alayhi was questioned about the Battle of Siffin, he said to the people, He said these were companions of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam, far more superior in knowledge than us, far more superior in taqwa than us, far more close to Allah and His Rasul than us. And so whatever they did was only for the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we can only praise them. And we can only praise them. This is very, very important to understand, my respected brothers and elders. There was no need in this meeting, Ali Azubillah, to depose Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala an from his position. No one can just remove the Khalifa from his position. Subhanallah al-Azim. And after the Battle of Siffin, the Muslims were in the most difficult position. Fitna, trials and tribulations had touched the Ummah. At this difficult moment, why would someone want to depose the Khalifa elected by the Muslims in Madinatul Munawwara? Why? And in front of them was also what Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala an had said to them. When Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala an passed away, he said, the Khalifa can only be from amongst the six. He can only be from amongst the six, from the Ashra Mubashara. And so after Hazrat Usman radiallahu ta'ala an, how many people were alive from the six that had been mentioned by Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala an? Only two. Hazrat Ali and Hazrat Sa'd ibn Abi Waqqas. As for Hazrat Sa'd ibn Abi Waqqas radiallahu ta'ala an, he was a different individual, not interested at all in Khilafat, a very Sufi individual. And so he said, no, I withdraw myself from this, and everything is with Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala. And so the only person that is left is Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala. And Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala also, mashallah, fits the criteria of that selection which is mentioned by the fuqaha, that who should be the Khalifa. And he is a Qurayshi. He is a Qurayshi and a man of good character, a man of knowledge. All the characteristics of a Khalifa were in Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala. And so for someone like Hazrat Musa al-Ashri or Hazrat Amr ibn al-As radiallahu ta'ala, such great individuals, intelligent individuals, for them to sit in the meeting, aliyazu billah, and talk about Khilafat and the issue of Khilafat, that who will become the Khalifa, is actually nonsense, which is concocted by Shia and the Rawafis. We need to understand that throughout history, when it comes to the chain of narrations, a lot of them were also people who were influenced by the Rawafis. And the Aqidah was the same as what we know today as people who are known as the Shia sect. That is why you will find that there is a lot of fazilat of Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala. A lot of fazilat of Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala. So what they would do is, in Arabic they would say, so and so, so and so, so and so, so and so has heard from Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam praising Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala. And so that is why you will find that many of the narrations are fabricated. And this is known as mawzu narrations. These are known as mawzu narrations. So we need to understand that. Hazrat Umar ibn Abdul Aziz rahmatullah alayhi was questioned with regards to the Battle of Siffin, and he gave a beautiful answer. They said to him, Hazrat, what is your opinion of the two groups? One of Hazrat Amir Muawiyah and one of Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala. Hazrat Umar ibn Abdul Aziz rahmatullah alayhi said that the likeness of the companions is like the eye. The likeness of the companions is like the eye. If you don't touch it, it will heal quickly. If you don't touch it, it will heal quickly. And so what he was saying is, don't talk about the companions of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal rahmatullah alayhi, what a great faqih. A few individuals came to him and they said, Hazrat, what about Hazrat Amir Muawiyah and Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala and that dispute? And Hazrat Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal rahmatullah alayhi said to them, Tilka ummatun qad khalat. And this is a nation that has passed away. Laha ma kasabat wa lakum ma kasabtum. They have received what they did and what they have earned. And you will receive what you do. They have received by Allah whatever they did, and you will receive what you do. لَهَا مَا كَسَبَتْ وَلَكُمْ مَا كَسَبْتُمْ وَلَا تُسْأَلُونَ عَمَّا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ. And Allah will not question you on the day of Qiyamah of their actions. And so he says, you must not talk about the companions of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Imagine that Allah has given them the certificate of Jannah. Allah is pleased with them. In every chapter of the Quran, Allah praises the companions of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam. So who are these individuals in their own books? And Allahu Akbar, uncorroborated historical narrations. And you'll find that some of the, in fact, many of the narrators are subject to criticism. Are subject to criticism. And there is no authenticity of these individuals to be great narrators. And so that is why we have to be very, very careful. InshaAllah ta'ala, we will stop at that. The meeting that took place was only to discuss how the procedure would be and what Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala an would do with the rebels, and how the family of Hazrat Osman radiallahu ta'ala an would be involved in this matter, in this case. That was the mashwara and the meeting at that time that had taken place. It was never to depose Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala an or to remove Hazrat Amir Muawiyah radiallahu ta'ala an from his position. Inshallah ta'ala, if Allah wills, in the next session of Dars-e Hadith, I will speak about some of the great individuals who had seen dreams about the companions who were with Hazrat Amir Muawiyah radiallahu ta'ala an, and also those who were with Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala an in the next session. And we also need to cover another group of people that came out known as the Khawarij, inshallah, in the future sessions if Allah wills. Wa akhiru da'wana alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Allahumma salli ala sayyidina wa nabiyyina wa maulana muhammadin nabiyil ummi wa ala alihi wa sallim taslima. Allahumma taqabbal minna wa tub alayna innaka antat tawwabur rahim. Nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk. Sami'na wa ata'na ghufranaka rabbana wa ilayka al-masir. Bi rahmatika ya arhamar rahimin.